Hello. How are you? Rudy, when we were talking to Alexander Bland, he remembers the day you arrived in England and he brought you to, took you to a restaurant quite near here, and he remembers very vividly the impression you made on him, right? Mm. Do you remember your feelings that day?
I have no memory whatsoever.
Really?
No recollection, no.
That's your first day in England, a new country, left Russia. Do you not remember it at all?
No, don't wash out.
But he took you to Covent Garden.
Yes, well, that I remember.
Ah.
I went to see Giselle, and I saw the way Margot danced, and I loved it very much.
So, what did you feel about Covent Garden?
Well, I thought it was... it didn't look like great opera house, you know. It looked to me like a cafe or something, you know, with a striped wallpaper, red and whatever it was.
And little lamps.
And the little lamps. It looked to me like a cafe, you know, like you would expect a boulevard theater in Paris somewhere.
So,
you know,
homelier than Russia?
Yeah.
What is Russia like then, the equivalent in Russia?
Well,
I
don't know, equivalent to Covent Garden, to that kind of decor would be, I don't know. We don't have that kind of thing there. Well, I'm kind of used to a more ostentatious setting.
If you're nervous, does it make it very difficult to dance effortlessly? Because nerves tighten you up, don't they?
Technically, you do very well.
Mm.
But I guess your inattention transmits to public. And since I think I'm a very good transmitter, anything I think or I do or about to do somehow transmit to public.
Doesn't it also transmit, though, to your partner? And if your partner's nervous, doesn't it transmit to you?
Well, usually a man's supposed to be there, you know, bunker of steel, and he sort of say, well, take it easy, relax. You know, sometimes they have a kind of reflex. When in doubt, they sort of strangle you.
But you could understand your reasons why you had to leave Russia, right?
Yes.
Partly because of your expression of yourself,
yes,
through your dance, yes?
So.
Now then, do you think that it's been harder for your mother to understand that?
Well, of course, I mean, it wasn't easy for her. On the other hand, I helped her to understand me when they called me. And of course, KGB or whatever provided with the telephone numbers where I was staying and how to get to me. And suddenly they were calling to me out of Russia. I mean, what do they know about Deauville? They never heard of Deauville. So anyway, they called me and reprimanded me for this and that and that. I say, right, mother, there is, you asked me many questions. There's one question you didn't ask me. So what is it? I say, you didn't ask me if I'm happy here. Ask me this question. Are you happy there? Yes, I am.